Good afternoon. Good evening, Mr. Gupta.
Good evening.
Can you tell me a little bit about what Kion does in India?
Well, we are into the business of material handling equipment manufacturing, especially the forklifts and warehousing equipments. And we are number one in India. We're holding around 30% market share, and we have a strategy of multi-brand strategy. We are lucky to have one of the best brands in the world. Since if you know Kion Group as such, it's around 8 billion euro company, around 30,000 employees, 14-15 manufacturing footprints, four of them in Asia Pacific, two in China, one in Australia, and one in India, that's at Pune. And in India we have we acquired Voltas as a brand in 2011, and we purchased this business from Voltas Limited. And today it's 100% subsidy of Kion Group, and it's a good growing company.
What are the sectors that you target? Because material handling usually means warehouses or ports. So what are the sectors that you target?
You see, our largest sector still is the industrial applications, because if you ask me, you know, India is a big scope, having a very big scope for material handling, and every industry require those kind of material handling equipment, especially our forklifts, and they are very popular inside the industry. At the same time, now slowly, you know, GST is coming in, so market will move from tax efficiency to operational management efficiencies. So I think warehousing equipment demands will also grow quite substantially. Just to give you a small example of the potential which is available in India, normally warehousing or material handling equipment are judged by how many pieces are being sold for 1 million of people, right? And for example, China is around 140 equipments for each million of person. Europe is 500 plus, US is 500 plus. A place like Africa is doing around 40 plus. And to my surprise, India is only 7. We are the smallest user of the equipment in the world, and therefore we think in India for the few years this demand will really, really grow very high.
So, but then if you look at it this way now, I mean, you mentioned, you know, in terms of millions and per million people, but then our density of population is higher. Like if you look at Europe or you look at America, the density of population is not so much, and they want a faster turnaround time compared to India, where, you know, our logistics takes like a Honda or a Maruti. If they want to transfer their cars from north to south or south to north, it's anywhere about 25 to 30 days, you know?
Yeah.
Each using each other's logistics and rail wagons. So how can companies adopt more mechanization? Because Indian companies are averse to mechanization. If they can use human labor, okay, very good, you know, it saves on cost. So how can companies like you convince them to adopt mechanization?
You see, first of all, I mean, that's... there are always something which is beyond the capacity of human being, right? And that's where normally the machinery comes in at that very moment, you know, and then the automation comes in. That's how the graduation takes place. So we stand at the initial state, okay, look after the human being, where the machinery actually comes in. One business of ours is also the warehousing management systems. And we have acquired one of the very large company in the world. We are one of the top three in warehousing automation business.
Which company is that?
This is a Dematic acquisition which we have done by a group by the last year. It's a $3.1 billion company, and we picked it up on cash basis last year. And we need to we also thinking in terms of bringing that product to India, because we think, you know, places like Amazon, places like e-commerce, you know, they have a vast utilization of these kind of automation needs, you know, and especially the GST coming in, trust me for this, things will go more on operational efficiencies than on the taxation efficiencies. And when you talk about the operational efficiencies, you cannot do without automation, it's impossible to handle. And that's why we say, sometimes the work goes beyond the human capacities. There the machinery automatically comes in.
Especially when you have large number of SKUs.
Of course.
Coming to German and Indian companies, so you are, your parent company is German and you are based out of India. What is the kind of support system or technology transfer, knowledge transfer that happens from Germany to India?
You see, I'll tell you, we are a very unique model, and we handle our entire strategy lies in multi-brand strategy. So it's mean we have brands which are famous in Europe, brands which are all over the world popular, some brands are in China, some brand in India like Voltas is Indian specific brands. So naturally there is a greater need for merging at some platform, how the technology transfer and how, so that we don't end up duplicating things. We have a very unique setup which is known as CTO organization, you know, and that's the central service unit, and which provides all technical supports, all purchasing supports centrally to all the units all over the world. Whereas sale and service networks, they are specific to the nations or specific to the brands, but as far as technical supports are concerned, it's centrally driven, and all integration of this part is taking place. I think it's a very unique and very fantastic way of running global businesses.
As a member of VDMA, what is the kind of initiatives that VDMA takes to support German companies in India, and how do you respond to
it? You see, I'm personally very, very high support of VDMA because it provides you the platform, first of all, right, of interaction. Whatever information you need from them, of your colleagues, of the possibilities, industrial inputs, investments which is happening in my own country, you will get all this input at one place. And then the supportive part, this kind of conference where you meet your peer group and you can interact with them, okay, what is the industry position, how is going the thing, and you can have broader view. Okay, at some time you also need some intervention coming from the common peer side, right? I think VDMA has been very successfully providing all these inputs to us from last so many years.
Going forward, what are some of the things that you want to bring in your products to India and all that? Large companies, you know, corporate corporates, you know, like a Ritual or maybe a PNG, you know, they need a lot of these mechanization, material handling equipment.
Hmm.
How can SMEs in India or MSMEs, like the aerospace industry makes large investments in MSMEs, you know, like, so how can these smaller companies be encouraged to invest in mechanization so that they can get a notch higher?
You see, we have one large part of business which is leasing and renting. Okay, and because we know one equipment may not be required but a small company for all the time, right? And we need to provide him that kind of setup. And we do have collaboration with so many small rental companies in India. At the same time, we have our own rental. You know, if you're looking for a long term and if you don't want to buy the assets, then we butt in and put all these assets and the financing from our side. And we take 3 to 5 years long term rental contract with the large multinationals. At the same time, when the requirement is on piecemeal basis and the customer is looking for a few days, then we have in every city, every town, we have some kind of operational arrangements where we can make those equipment made available to our customers.
Thank you so much.
Grateful. Thank you very much.